This is part five of percents, and we're going to continue writing percents as fractions, just a few more slightly trickier problems. So we're going to write the following four percents as fractions on this video. This is part five of percents, and we're going to continue writing percents as fractions. So remember, percent, remember, think of percent, it means out of 100, divide by 100. So one way of getting rid of a percent and writing as a fraction is remembering that you could replace the percent symbol with divided by 100, or you could replace the percent symbol with times 1 over 100, since dividing by 100 is the same thing as multiplying by the fraction 1 over 100. So in parts 3 and 4, we also learn how to write percents as fractions, and we're going to do a little bit more complicated ones on this video. So we've got write 14.2% as a fraction. All right, there's a couple things here. First of all, I've got 14.2, which is a decimal, not a fraction, right? There's a decimal point. And then I have a percent sign, and I want to get rid of the percent sign to write my whole answer as a fraction. So there's two steps here, and there's more than one way of doing this problem, but here's one way. 14.2, what does that mean? So we'll start out with 14.2%, and we're going to write down what 14.2 means. It means 14 and 2/10. So you already have to know about decimals and how to change that to a fraction, 14 and 2/10. So I have 14 and 2/10, and also I can work with this percent sign. I can change it to times 1 over 1/100. So this is how we could start this problem. 14.2% is the same thing as 14 and 2/10 times 1 over 100. All right, now how do you multiply with fractions? Well, you need to change this 14 and 2/10 into an improper fraction, but I also may as well reduce this 2/10. I'm going to reduce first. You can change it to an improper fraction and reduce, or reduce first. So I'm going to rewrite this as 14 1/5. Right, because 2/10 reduces to 1/5. And then I now need to rewrite 14 1/5 as an improper fraction. So that's 5 times 14 is 70 plus 1. 71 is in the numerator over 5 times 1 over 100. And now we can multiply across to get 71 over 500. And that is how to write 14.2%. as a fraction. That's what it's actually equal to. Okay, so that's one approach to do it. I'm going to do it one more way for those of you who don't want to write this as a mixed number first, 14 and 2/10. So let's try another method. So we're going to do the same problem. Write 14.2% as a fraction. What you could do is go directly to writing this as an improper fraction. So what you notice is only one number after the decimal point, so this is going to be in tenths, and then you just write the number 142 in the numerator. So instead of writing 14 and 2/10, you could just write 142/10. Then what about the percent sign? Well, I still have to write that as times 1 over 100. Okay, and now we can cancel. We should get exactly the same answer, except you've got an option how you want to cancel. How about with 142 and 100, I say what goes into both of those numbers? Well, 2 goes into both of those numbers, so if we divide top and bottom by 2, so divide 142 by 2 is 71, and divide 100 by 2, we get 50. Then in the numerator, I have 71. And in the denominator, I have 500. So I've got that 14.2% equals 71/500ths again, just like we did before. Let's take a look. Remember, this is how we did it the first way. I think it's easier to change this to 14 2/10 first. Personally, I'd rather have that when I'm doing my reducing. It's an easier number, 2/10. I simply reduce that. Whereas here, you have a bigger number, 142. But they both will yield the same answer as long as you completely reduce your answer. So I'm going to give one for you to try now. All right, so I want you to write 8.3% as a fraction. So put the video on pause and try that on your own and then come back and see how I do it. Okay, so we're going to start off with 8.3%, and you can write that as just 8 and 3 tenths. 8.3 could be written as 8 and 3 tenths, that's the meaning. And then with a percent sign, we could change that to 1 over 100. Now, 8 and 3 tenths, well, the 3 tenths cannot be reduced. So if I change that to an improper fraction, we have 10 times 8 plus 3, that's 83 tenths times 100th. Nothing cancels, and there's your answer. 83 over 1,000. So 8.3% equals 83 over 1,000. And if you had gone directly by writing 8.3 as a fraction, still there's one place after the decimal, so there's the 10 in the denominator, and you just write the number 83, 83 tenths. So you could have gone straight to this problem, which is the next step, if you had written it as 8 and 3 tenths, since nothing canceled here anyway. Okay, in another problem, maybe something would have canceled. Here's another one for you to try. Write 2.12% as a fraction. So put the video on pause and try it on your own first. Okay, so let's do this. We've got 2.12%, and you know, there's more than one way you could start it. I'm going to do it by writing this as a mixed number. The whole part's 2. And I've got 0.12. Remember, that means 12 over 100. And then the percent sign divided by 100 or times 1 over 100. Notice on all of these problems, I always began by writing times 1 over 100. That was just to save the step of doing it at the second step, because dividing by 100 is the same thing as multiplying by 100. So you could have just written 212 over 100 and you'd have an improper fraction right off the bat. That's fine. All right, but I'm going to do it by reducing first. So I've got 2, and what number goes into 12 and 100? 4. So that's going to be 2 and 3/25 times 100th. Now I'm going to write this. Now I'm going to write it as an improper fraction. So that's going to be 53 25ths. Remember how I get that? 25 times 2 plus 3 is the new numerator. So my answer is 53 over 2,500. So 2.12% is the same thing as 53 over 2,500. Now, again, you could have simply written this as 212 over 100 in the beginning. So just going to write it over here. If you wanted, you could have written 212 over 100, because there's two places after the decimal point this time. So there's 100 in the denominator, times 1 over 100th. And then you could have reduced by canceling. So you could say, well, 4 goes into both of these numbers. So 4 into 100 would be 25, and 4 into 212 happens to be 53. It's just, for me, it's easier to reduce 12 hundredths, dividing 4 into 12 as opposed to 212. So keep in mind, that's perfectly fine. If that's easier to just write 212 over 100, that's okay. So we have 53 over 2,500. It does take less steps. Right? See how it's actually less steps? But I just think the arithmetic might be easier if you reduce the 12 hundredths. So the choice is yours, whatever's easiest for you. All right, we've already done problems like this, but just as a little review, let's go and do this one more time. Write 524% as a fraction. Notice it's over 100%. So I'm going to split this up. That 524%, and that's really 500% plus the 24%. Remember how we could do that? Oops, what's going on here? All right. So 500%, is 5. Hopefully you can do that without writing this first, but if you want, you could first write 500. Remember that percent means divide by 100. And over here, divide by 100. So we have 5 plus, and then all we need to do is reduce 24 hundredths. Divide the top and bottom by 4, gives you 6 25ths. So this is 5 and 6 25ths. So that was just a little review, if you have something over 100%, how you might work something like that. Okay, so we've done lots of videos and lots of examples. Just keep practicing. It depends if you want to write your percent as a fraction or a decimal, how you might start the problem. So you might want to go back now and review videos 1 through 5 if you need to. Okay, you can do it.